Here's a quick question for today. Somebody wants fab tips. One of our jointhefoot.com supporters asks this question. Yo, 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 ballers.
Yo.
I just entered my first league that uses fab. Any tips for how I should adjust my waiver strategy? Thanks and keep up the great work. What do you think? What is a hot fab tip?
I mean, first off...
15 seconds or less. I'm sorry.
First off, it depends on the league. Are these players all new to the fab system? Because that will change things as well. And my tip for that is don't be afraid to spend some money in week one and week two. People, when they're brand new to the system...
What if some of our listeners right now are brand new to hearing that term?
Oh, free agent acquisition?
It's a water-based waiver system.
That's how it would be fob. Yes. Acquisition.
No, I should not have provoked an explanation. That was my fault.
Essentially, it's a way for you to manage your waivers. You make a blind bid to add a player off the waiver wire, to acquire a player off of...
Acquire.
Yes. Off of the waiver wire, instead of just having the reverse order of standings where...
Yes.
You have no say in who you're going to get off the waiver wire. This makes it a little bit more fair, adds a huge element of fun and strategy to the league. We recommend it for everybody. But people who are brand new to it generally get a little bit greedy and hoarding with the money. So, number one, don't be afraid to spend it. But
yeah,
two,
gun shy, right? They want to hold it till the end. They don't want to be left, you know, without money.
And you should have some money at the end. But like, let's say you are... going into a league and they're used to it. You know, number one, stick around to the show because when we talk about waivers on every Tuesday's episode, we do break down our favorite players off of the waiver. We talk about how much of our budget would we spend. You're like, oh, no, I'll throw down 12% to go after that player. But that, I mean, that's what it's about. It's about prioritizing the player that you want. And sometimes you have to make a decision of, if I wake up in the morning and see that I have lost out on that player, then bid more.
Yeah, that's the question that I think is really helpful. Is if I were to have spent $2 more and get the player, would I be upset if I wasted $2 and set your budget? But I agree with Mike. It's really, when I think about the fab system, it's about the timeline of the season. Like, that's the tips and tricks that I have for the fab system. Is in the beginning of the year, guys are just worth more. Don't be afraid to buy them. They give you more weeks. If you were to get a guy after week one who becomes a valuable player for your team and you have him for 15 more weeks versus getting a guy right before playoffs who gives you one or two games, if you just think about the dollar per week that you're getting for that player, it's fantastic. And the other thing is, I always save like $5 of fab to go into my playoffs. So if I spent up big in the beginning and week four I'm down to $5 in fab, mentally I say I have zero fab dollars, because unless I'm out of the running and need to get back into the running for the playoffs. Because,
and hopefully your league accepts $0 bids.
Yes,
that should be on for every league. There should not be a, you have to have a dollar to claim someone off the waivers. That's ridiculous.
Oh, hey, I was just doing some trades. Got some good players here. Why don't you click subscribe and I'll share my secrets.